Hey everyone, it's Red Lace, and today I am playing Stardew Valley. And apparently I need a torch on my head, because, you know, that's how I wake up in the morning. It is summer year 2, the 12th, and my sound in my headphones has blasted me out, so I need to turn that down, because otherwise I'm going to scream at everybody all morning. Oh, I can hear. No birthdays today, but Alex's birthday is tomorrow. Tara loves to lay on you when she's in the mood. Lexus always wants on me now. She didn't used to be like that. It's just since we moved, she's like super cuddle bug. I don't know what her deal is. Hi, Weedle. How are you today? Dog likes to watch boyfriend play video games. It's adorable. Oh, totally. Post a photo. That sounds so cute. Manly likes watching games too, but he doesn't like Minecraft. Minecraft scares the bejesus out of him and he'll go running for the hills. And he'll like arch his back and stuff when an ocelot's around. He'll think it's like another cat. He freaks out. So you can't play Minecraft near Manly. Nope. Looks like a storm is approaching. Thunder and lightning is expected, which is wonderful. Battery pack time for me. I'm doing lovely, Weedle. Thank you for asking. Spirits are perturbed today. They're not in the best mood. Luck will not be on my side. So I've upgraded my axe, and I believe Clint has it today. So I'm going to have to go get it from him, because I think it should be ready. Red Lace, I made you a little treat this morning in the saloon. Dig in your friend Gus, and he gave us a bean hat. Sorry for the noise. My water is blocking my left side of my screen, and my speaker's blocking the right, so I gotta move some stuff around. Hi, Sabrine! How's your evening? Change of environment's probably the case. I noticed that Tara and Xander have some behavior changes like that too when we moved into our current place. That might make sense. Does Manly like first-person shooters? I don't think he minds them so much. He likes Skyrim. Skyrim lulls him to sleep. He watches that. But first-person shooters, I don't know. He used to kind of freak out when I was playing COD, so probably not so much. I don't think it's his favorite thing in the world. But, you know, what can you do? I moved my seeds. You guys weren't here to see, but I moved my seeds up here. Because they were in my way. So now they're up here. I need to plant something else for summer. Because now I have an empty spot. Pepper? 5 days. Let's do a pepper. Pepper! Pepper! Ba-bam! All good, Sabrine? Oh, that's good to hear. Glad to hear it. Who's this? This is Ben. Ben! Kinda got burnt off on Stardew Valley. Making a lot of money in the beginning makes the second year kind of snooze. Oh yeah. Well, you notice my schedule, I've drastically cut down on the Stardew Valley time. So I'm with ya. But it's probably a perfect game for me to play today. Lark, because I didn't feel very good yesterday. I think I got explosioned to death. I don't know. I had a killer headache, and so today I'm kind of looking forward to the mellow time. Matt looks fine. Everybody's doing so good. All my subs are so happy. One Robo. Who's down here lingering? Megan, you're blocking the door! Other way around, White Owl. Other way around. There you go. There you go. Walks in, pushes Sabrina into Red's pond, and says hello to everyone else. Oh, that's nice, Raven. Howdy doody. Rude. He's soaked now, Weedle says. It was rude, now the pond's ruined. At least I never locked your keys in your car. Oh, that's not fair. I've locked my keys in my car. And it sucks. Hey, what do you have a goat named after me? Bolt, if you want an animal named after you, I name all my animals after my subscribers. It's a current bonus I'm offering all my subs. And if you'd like to subscribe to get all sorts of fantastical benefits, you can type an exclamation sub into chat to see all the benefits that are available. Or you can visit my website at redlacegaming.com and there's a subscribe button there. Oh, I just tried to milk Matt. Sorry, Matt, you're a pig. Blame your father. Oh boy. Thank you for the follow, X-Runa. You are fantastical, meow. Welcome to the stream. Which reminds me. I meant to send out a tweet and I had it sitting here open, but I never actually hit the button. So, we're tweeting now. Watched it on YouTube? Nice. Milk that pig like a boss? Oh, don't you worry. Matt won't mind. It's okay. He'll forgive me. Forgot a word I meant to say that you have a goat with my real name. Oh, I do, Bolt. What's your first name? I'm guessing it's not one of the ones like, you know, Feralia. Yes, Raven is in second place because he's fantastical! Okay, let's check on the other subs. Where's everybody at? Taco! Raven! Raven's at full hearts. Sabrine's almost at full hearts. He's got a half a heart to go. Amber! Amber, you are a duck. Quack! Rose is at full hearts. So close to Phoenix White Owl? Nice. I thought I just saw an animal. Oh, there he is. This is probably Weedle. Yep, Weedle! We're having animal shout-out today. Ah, Ben! Gotcha, Bolt. Yeah, that's our... my sub, Ben Chromatic. That's who that was named after. Just made yourself some ham and cheese and sunny-side-up fried egg sandwiches. That sounds good. I had eggs for lunch myself, Phoenix. I had roasted sweet potatoes and fried egg over the top. I was hoping to get some rosemary on there too, but I only like fresh rosemary and my rosemary went bad. Haven't eaten it in a few days, so it was all black and ugh. It was kind of boring, but it was good. It was good. Packed full of potassium and stuff. Okay, so I got my 5 mayonnaise, and so now I need to go to... saloon and do that thing to get that statue and stuff. I also need to go down to Marnie's to buy an animal and retrieve my axe. Raven, you're all fantastical. Never naughty, just downright destructive. I'd say that's pretty accurate. Downright destructive. Okay, so I moved my horse, Crimson, which you may or may not have noticed, because I didn't move very far. But I'm intending to move my horse stables somewhere else, because it's bothering me where it is, and I need to get away to come up and down to this other area, because right now it's so far away I can't actually get down here. And the things are one wide, so the horse won't always go up and down, which is a big problem, because if I need to go from the bottom to the top of my farm, I can't do it. So I'm gonna have to do something about the horse situation, and maybe my pathways, and make them double wide, which I'm not very pleased on. But it is what it is, and I gotta do it, so... Bummer, yo. Pepper party hype! This one tree is being a brat. Like, what? What is your dilemma? What's stalling this here? It's starting to get more windy here? Are you expecting some atrocious weather? I shouldn't have done that, because now I can't fix it. Someone remind me next time I come back here to fix that. My sister just moved down to Puerto Rico on Monday. She was traveling all day on Halloween. I think she left at 4 a.m. on Halloween and got to Puerto Rico at 3:45 a.m. the next day. So It's a long day for her. Okay, my first sheep! And it's gonna be Pudding, my newest sub. Yay, Pudding! I have an idea, make a path that goes all around the farm in the corner so you can ride your horse. That's a good idea, actually. I can just make a big circle all around the sides. I like that plan, White Owl. I might do it. I'm not gonna do it today, because I think it's gonna take a while. So I might do it off stream, because it's gonna be a pain, and you guys don't want to sit through me decorating. Pudding Pop Panda is my newest sub. She gets a sheep, because she's fantastical. Right, I'll send Little Pudding her new home right away. I got bored the other night, so I leveled an entire mountain on the Minecraft server with my explosives. Jeez. I have to say, it was pretty fun, and during this activity, only one animal was harmed, the pig I killed for lunch. That's not bad if you only killed one animal. No, it gets that way around this time of year. Means it's starting to cool down. Oh, okay. Bahama weather. Windy in the fall. Gotcha. Hopefully it's not like hurricane windy. I'll have new items every week, so make sure to come back, no? Today she's selling a truffle, which I totally need for a bundle, so we're buying it, because Matt's not digging me one up very quickly. Sea urchin, rhubarb seeds, basic fertilizer. I don't think I have any rhubarb, but that's okay. Cave carrot, clay, slime, coffee bean, tulip bulb, VGA paradise, and a rare seed and a coffee bean. Do I want to buy a rare seed? I think I'm going to buy that, just because then I can have it in my inventory. Alright, Spring, we'll see when you get back. Yeah, congrats to Raven on only killing one pig. What a good day for him. Do I still have room on the Red Velvet server? Oh yeah, there's plenty of room, Amber. Have you logged in yet? You can get a room in the motel, should you want a temporary place to call home or a permanent one. There's plenty of rooms available in the motel, and all you gotta do is pick your room number and then private message me, and I will slap your name on the door and decorate it for you. You're on the same weather pattern as Phoenix. It's starting to get nicer weather. Interesting. Here it's just foggy. Fall here is just fog and rain. And so, like last night, those of you that were here for the later stream, out my window out here, it looked really bright, but it was just fog. And so the city lights were reflecting off the fog. I got a gold pickaxe, guys! Yay! One tool down, lots to go. Okay, so let's go take the truffle and we'll do the mayonnaise. Haley and Alex are flirting at the ice cream stand. Thought about checking it out, but Don't Starve distracted you. It sounded like you had a good time, though. That's what's important, right? That you had fun? It's all good. Have a tomato, Sam. Oh, Sam. This is interesting. I know it's not blueberries. I don't have any. Here it's cold and snowy. So jealous, Megan. So jealous. Hi, Matt! How are you? You know, I used to live in the city, and I have to admit, this place is much nicer in the summer. Ooh, cutscene. The rain starts to slow down and we have an amazing winter temps of the whole freezing 75 to 80. Yeah, Florida's just not the place for me. Hi, Red Lace. Yeah, today I'm really rocking the Seattle look. I got a flannel shirt on, y'all. Plaid flannel. What do you think of them apples? That's a Seattle thing. I'm just looking over last month's earnings, and it's not looking very good, Red Lace. The worst thing, and I hate to say this because she's my friend, is Pam. She hasn't paid her tab in weeks. But I can't ask her to do it. I know she'll get defensive, and I don't want to hurt her feelings. I spent at least 2 days clearing all of Matt's skeletons and Don't Starve. Hi, Jack. How are you today? Red Lace, you gotta help me. So sick of the monsters and Don't Starve. At least I got it so you don't freeze or overheat when you leave camp. Well, that's good, Matt. So nice of you to do that for everybody. What a pal. Hiya. Gus, I'm awfully thirsty, if you catch my drift. redneck, red lace, and her flannel. Yeah, this is the comfiest flannel ever. I don't know if you guys have Patagonia where you are, but I got it from Patagonia, and oh, it's so soft and snuggly. well, okay, Pam. Oh, Amber messed it up. Uh-oh. Amber said she played last night, like, all night long. She woke up at 3 a.m. and she'd been playing till forever. She said we're in spring now, in the rain. Pam is such Raven. Red Lace, what's going on here? You need to pay your tab right now, or the saloon isn't doing well financially. Let's tell her the honest truth. It isn't? That's terrible! Oh. And she's embarrassed. And now she's flaming mad. Well, I guess I'd better pay off that tab then. Thanks, Pam. And thank you, Red Lace. Now, let's get you that drink, Pam. Tried hard, I got certain things I hope you didn't get rid of. I got stingers and rot to make vaccines. Vaccines? What? What do you need vaccines for? I'm so behind. Okay, so we're putting the 5 duck mayonnaise into this thingy. And then magical things happen and we get my favorite statue. It's the one with the little red Pippi Longstocking stockings and the heart on the head. Statue hype! Okay. So we'll have to put that back in our house when we get there. Let's go do the truffle. It would have helped Matt had I known you were doing stuff in there. I was blowing stuff up on Minecraft and shooting the NPCs in the Division. Yeah, you were hard at work. Help wanted. Try and keep the artificial alive. I'll pay 150 gold to any fishing enthusiast who catches 3 chub. Good luck, Willy. 150 gold reward and you'll get to keep the fish. Fishy fish. Where are chub? Chub are in just the rivers, right? Rivers or lakes, I think. So that'd be an easy one. Don't worry, it was mostly sitting around as a ghost waiting for time to pass. It's probably a good way to go about it in such situations. Okay. You know, I have the cabbage at my house. I forgot to bring it. Oops. Chef's bundle. Complete. Recommend the first thing you already make is a thermostone, though. I made one before I got off the server. Remember, I was using it in winter when we were getting bombarded by penguins. 3 pink cake. Booyah. Okay. So I need to come back with my cabbage. My cabbagey. Hey, Mary Lewis, have a tomato. Thanks, this is great. I wonder if it's anyone's birthday today. I'd better check the calendar by Pierre's shop. So I need to get a birthday gift for Alex, speaking of. And I don't know if I have any salmon, so I might need to think of something else. Let's see if we can catch 3 chub real fast. You made a crock pot, a bunch of drying racks, a tree farm, moved the beefalo closer, and put down one of those map things so you can see where I've been. Oh geez, that sounds like a lot of good stuff. So hopefully that makes up for the stingers I stole. Sounds like you were busy, Amber. Doing lots of good work. Pike. Not a chub. How do you move the beefalo and don't starve? How do you do that? I didn't know you could do that. One of the giants killed a bunch of beefalo, so I had to move another herd closer. Giants? There's giants? What? What? Guys, am I fishing in the right spot for chub? Because I don't feel like I'm getting any. I just don't know. And you know, it'd all be worth it if I could get a dino egg. hint hint game. You know what else I'd like to do? I would like to upgrade my chicken coop to the last tier so I can unlock rabbits. Can't remember what I need for that, but I think I have the money almost. I think it's 20,000, isn't it? Or is it 25,000? I don't remember. I'm only getting pike. This is not working out. I don't think this is the spot. Oh, that's okay, Amber. There's so much stuff I don't know about Don't Starve, It's Fine. I'm learning from you guys talking about it. Otherwise, I'd be dead all the time. I'm a Don't Starve noob. I've only played it maybe like 6 times now. I think I've been doing alright for being as new as I am to it. With the help of you guys. You guys and your overachieving here. I was all happy it lasted more than 5 days. I'm with you, Raven. Those 5 days, they make a difference, right? Okay. Let's see what I got. Tomatoes. Looks like I can use that tomato. Peppers. Looks like I have plenty of peppers, so I'll be able to make lots of hot peppers. I still need to know what to get Alex. Got 3 dynamics in summer year, 1 from worms in front of Robin's house. That's so lucky, I just don't have that luck. But I got the money, honey. Well, you got the dino eggs. Chubs are caught in the river or the mountain lake. Ah, thanks, Exruna. Maybe I just, it was too late. Maybe I'll go check tomorrow and try again tomorrow. Because I do need to go up tomorrow anyway and take this cabbage up to the community center. Has Matt the Pig found you a truffle yet, or did you have to take him to the slaughterhouse? No, Matt the Pig has not found me a truffle yet, and I actually bought a truffle from the traveling merchant and used it for my community center bundle just now, because I got sick of waiting. So yeah, Matt the Pig's been just enjoying the summertime sunshine. Welcome back, Sabrine. Yeah, Don't Starve does take a while to learn. It's deceptively more difficult than I anticipated. Solo record's 34 days? That's awesome. Wish mine was 34 days. 34 days would be groovy! Okay. Do I have Breen? I do. What about Pike? I got a couple extra Pike. One time during your solo game, you got hounds at night. Oh jeez, that's terrible luck. That's terribly unfortunate. That just had to suck. And had to run in circles for my fire until daylight came. I was doing that on the server when winter was there and the hounds came. I just ran in circles. It was very productive. Mm-hmm. And it's my dad. Matt the Pig is such a disappointment. Oh, he's still got time to turn it around. He's still new. He's a young guy. A young pig. Bean hot pot. Got the deer clops at night 2 days ago, but it was all good because it was already dead. Didn't have to worry about him then, right? So I was planning on moving my coop down here, so I knocked out the fence because that was part of my plan to widen this pathway. But I might have to rethink that plan. Might have to rethink it. And luckily I remember that I need to come down and fix that thing I messed up down here, so we'll do that real fast. As I tilled some soil, if this one tree would grow, my tree tapper farm would be complete. And that would be lovely. Lovely indeed. I think I probably need to make a couple more lightning rods tonight before the storm hits tomorrow, just in case. So iron, refined quartz, and batwing. let's do that. Iron, refined quartz, and that thing. I do not want my tree farm, my fruit trees, going up in smoke. So we're gonna remedy this situation real fast. Just to be on the safe side. That nothing happens to my pretty little trees. Why do I have this back here? This is messed up. That should be down one. I'll have to fix this. This is not right. And then this can be a double wide and my horse can get through. Ta-da! Okay, I'll just need to make more fence. I got fence problems. Anyway. Okay. And then, I don't know if I have any down here either. We better check. Probably gonna just stick one, like, right here. Just in case. These trees. Could that be the worst if one of my trees goes poof? After I spent so long waiting for them to grow. Let's stick another one here. Okay. Alright, now we're good. I feel safer now. Better go to bed. Deerclops wiped out 15 beefalo? Seriously? Wow. That meat and fur got you through the winter, so you're not mad? Oh, that's good. Dual purpose. Yeah, someone just told me that you had to get fur from beefalo. I didn't know that was a thing. I had to go on a long journey and hunt for gold. Survived over 3,000 days on Arxor without death. But a simple game like Don't Starve murders you repeatedly, and Don't Starve doesn't even have man-eating vicious dinos. No, everything else eats man. Every single animal in that game, even the frogs. 10,932 gold! Okay, does anybody know what I need for the chicken coop final upgrade? Because I would love to go do that, and I can't recall, and I don't have my guide open because I'm a slacker. So anyone that could help, that'd be fantastical. It's going to be clear and sunny all day. Went exploring when I was dead in summer last night. Unfortunately, it didn't fill in the map. Oh no! Yeah, I thought when you're a ghost it doesn't do any of the map stuff. Spirits are somewhat annoyed today. Boo, spirits. Boo. Hey Red, remind me to set the wyverns to eat Sabrine when he logs in the Ark server. you too. Dear Red Lace, I was conducting a field study the other day and I found this specimen. I hope you find it as interesting as I did, Demetrius. A bream! Thanks, Demetrius. You're a pal. Looks like my wheat's ready. Now I need more seeds again. What to plant? Okay. Cross your fingers, guys, for a giant melon. Because I've had really, really terrible luck in the melon department, or the giant crop department. And I've been trying since year one for giant crops, and have yet to get one. So, cross your fingers that I get one this time. I need to go buy more stuff from Pierre today. I need seeds. 500 wood and 200 stone. How much money is it, though? I have 500 wood and 200 stone. How much gold is it? Do you know, Xruna? Hi, Omer! How are you? You know what Stardew Valley needs? Auto harvesters? Or maybe a tractor? That would be cool if they had, like, farm equipment. That'd be pretty neat. stream starts at 12 noon every day, Omer. Every day. You can type an exclamation up in the chat to see how long I've been live. Someone's a little touchy today, wrong time of the month. Now, now, Sabrine. That's a little insulting to the female audience around here. Please refrain. Insult Raven all you'd like, but come on. Don't insult us ladies. Coop is 20,000 gold, 500 wood, and 200 stone. Xruna agrees. Okay, thank you guys. Thanks, man. I'm gonna go do that today. We're gonna upgrade. We're gonna upgrade. Yeah. And then I'll have 9,000 left so I can buy crops on the way back. Can swing around. And I'll check on the animals when I come back too. Auto harvest would be nice, I know, right? I know, right, Amber? It is. Only dudes make those jokes. I'd like magic spells that help with farming. Oh yeah, the Europeans' clocks change before US, so our daylight savings isn't until this Sunday, so the time's probably going to be a little wonky for you for the next week. I heard some people are having a little confusion with that, but yeah, the daylight savings for us is on Sunday. Sunday? It's Sunday, right? I hope it's Sunday. I'm planning on getting that extra hour of my Sunday. Better be real. Want to hire the Junimos to do the farm work for you? That'd be awesome. You put little Junimos in, on tractors out in your garden. Cutscene! Oh, hello there. You know, I really don't like Maru. She's kind of a nerdy snot. Like, out of all the characters, she's probably my least favorite. Just saying. Oh yeah, I was wondering why the stream started 2 hours earlier. Yeah, White Owl. Times change right about now. My dad and I are just testing some soil samples. Junimos with little straw hats would be so cute. Oh yeah, they would. And overalls. Don't be shy. We could use a hand, actually. Could you watch this beaker for me? I'm gonna grab the last batch of samples. I'll be right back. Sure, Maru. Cat Girl has just upgraded their subscription to Crimson. Oh my goodness, Cat! Oh my goodness! Let's give Cat Girl some hugs in chat! Thank you so much for the continued support, and be sure to check out Game Wisp in a little while. It takes a little bit to update, but when it does, check back later today because it'll probably ask you a few more questions so I can fulfill your new benefits. So, woohoo! Thank you, Cat Girl! Thank you so much! The first Crimson Tier sub! Yay! Yay! Crimson Co-op hype! Crimson Co-op hype! Crimson Co-op hype! Do 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 do! Okay. 415 fantastical hugs going to Cat Girl! Can you whisper that to me? I want to know, please. Whisper what to you, Cat? Are you talking to me or somebody else? If it's a video about what you can do to eliminate a certain thing, then I know about it. What are you guys talking about? I think I missed something because I got excited. I got distracted by fantasticalness and Cat Girl herself. Maru's a good kid. She's my special little girl. I bet she is. I wouldn't want anything getting in the way of her bright future. Know what I mean? My dad's still texting me. Dad, I'm sorry, I'm busy. I'll have to get back to you. Just some food for thought. Demetrius, you're weird. No problem, Red. I love watching your streams, and I'm glad my schedule is completely messed up so I could be here. Aw, me too, Kat. Thank you. Oh, they're talking about Stardew spoilers. Okay, I totally missed it then. Yeah, don't tell me what you're talking about. Huge spoilers are not allowed in this lobby. No me gusta. Hey, sorry about that. I hope you found something to talk about while I was gone. We sure did. I was just telling Red Lace about the soil samples we're testing.
Lies. Lies.
Right, Red Lace? Actually, your dad is being weird. Ugh. Huh? What'd you say to her, Dad? That he's weird. Red, if you unlock the sewers, try going to Krobus on Friday and get iridium sprinklers for fall. I do know he sells iridium sprinklers somewhere, but I don't want to buy them because I'm trying to do upgrades for my tools and my farm currently. So I'll keep that in mind, but that's not really what I'm going for at the moment. Saw a video about swimming with the Junimos this late game, but I can't say other than Raven wasn't too far off the mark. That's too much information! Devils! No! No, 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 no. Even that. Spoilers, people! Just stop. Hi, Danny Chan. I'm so happy you made it to another stream as well. Sorry you had to come in while I'm yelling at these guys. Okay, we were talking about you, sweetie. I wanted to say a few things Red Lace about you, but I didn't want to embarrass you. I shouldn't have lied about it. You're done talking about the Junimos. Exclamation on that one. It's kaput. Ravenhole Gaming eats popcorn and watches Red Swinger ban hammer at Devil's Warning. Yes, thank you, Megan. Thank you. That's okay, Dad. I understand. We should get back to work before these samples crystallize. Robin, my dear friend, I came here to see you. Hello. Frozen. No. No, no, not this again. Okay, good. The deluxe coop unlocks rabbits with an auto-feed system, 12 coop-dwelling animals, 20,000 gold, 500 wood, and 200 stone. Let's build it. Hi, Pagan7, how are you today? Homer, you're pushing my buttons right now. Don't even. Spoilers? Don't even. I'm not having it today. I just said, absolutely no spoilers. Let's not even wink wink. No, no. Nothing. I will time out people. Okay, I'll start working on your coop upgrade first thing tomorrow morning. Purple office chair. You're doing well, Pagan. That's fantastical. I'm glad to hear it. Thank you for the follow, Crumbling Roses. You are fantastical, Meow. Welcome to the stream. Indoor palm trees? Well, who doesn't want an indoor palm tree, right? A candle lamp. Kinda wanna buy it, but I got stuff I gotta go get. I need sap or seeds from the farm. Yeah, I put a tree tapper way out here. It seemed like a good idea at the time. Okay, let's take the cabbage to the community center and finish the other bundle. Mentioned that yesterday, but I forgot. Oh, thanks, Crumbling Roses, for coming back today and hitting that follow button. I really appreciate it. We'll say this because it's just a rule. If someone drop a spoiler, it'll be their last you do drop, because the timeout timer I will deliver to you will stop all typing in here the rest of the day. Just saying. Yeah, I don't like spoilers. Everybody knows this that comes here regularly. I do not like spoilers. It is in the rules. No spoilers. A seed maker, I can make good use of that. So the only two I'm missing is the enchanters, and I'm waiting on my fruit trees for both of these. I need a pomegranate there and 3 apples here, so in fall we shall finish the bulletin board. Really bummed today because 2 crops were killed in cold blood this morning where you live. Or 2 cops. I said crops, I'm sorry. It's been an emotional day. I'm sorry, Danny Chan. Sorry to hear that. I did see that on the news. I did see that on Google this morning when I got on at the coffee shop. today's Alex's birthday, and I still don't have a gift for him, everybody. What to give him? I could go see if I can make a complete breakfast. I'm looking for someone to bring me 30 copper ores for inspection. Clint, 340 gold on delivery, and you can keep the ores after Clint inspects them. I might have 30. I need to go back and accept it. I didn't take it. Alright, we're going to plant more melons. I think I have enough time. That's 12, 25. 25 days? Yeah. 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. I need 16 melons. And then we'll do 16 of those. 16 of those. Corn. Might as well do corn because it'll stay through fall. Cabbage. Okay. I think we're good. We're good here. Glad you planted your apple tree in summer year one. I will do that bundle earlier. Yeah, I didn't get mine in time. Give him back his crappy wallpaper from your original playthrough with a note that says learn to decorate better. That'd be a great birthday gift for Alex. I agree, Raven. I don't read the news really ever, but I went to a different coffee shop today, and because I went to a different coffee shop, I need to take these to the community center. What am I doing? I almost sold them. I can get my greenhouse now, y'all! That's all I'm waiting on! I don't read the news, but today I went to a different coffee shop, and so to get on the internet I had to go to Google, and so I saw it there because it's the main headline. I didn't read the article, I just saw the headline. Married Leia, 2 days after she made your bedroom purple, floor purple. She does that. She does that. Like how the first day you started living with Sebastian, he watered your crops and made you lunch. Well, that was nice of him. Okay, greenhouse. And now you're mine. Junimo hype! How do you make your farm look so good? My farm is so ugly compared to yours. I spend way too much time decorating crumbling roses. Like, it's ridiculous. I mean, I make a huge time suck out of decorating. Like, I could spend a whole season decorating. It's bad. It's bad. I think I put a priority on my farm's looks over its efficiency. So, you know. Just depends what you're going after, and me, I like to decorate, so I spend way too much time doing it, because that's one of my favorite parts of the game, so... Yeah... I'm so excited! I get my greenhouse! Leia's the purple monster of destruction, she's pure evil. Yes, Matt knows. I spend too much time and money decorating my farm. I do indeed. And that's the way, I like it. I like my overly decorated everything. It makes me happy. So I will continue to do so. Devils likes decorating too? Nice. Yeah, I fall asleep on my farm a lot decorating. That's true. I do that often. It's a problem. It's a problem. It's a hard knock problem, because... Okay, let's get some of these in here. Cabbagey. What's back here? A pepper. How did that appear? I didn't even see it. And then we're gonna get corn down here. Because we're going to get corny with our bad selves. And then... At least the day she made my floor purple, she gave me a salad. Also, you have your catalog. Oh, catalog's nice. Well done. Well done. Raven, maybe you should just start embracing the color purple, and then people can't use it against you. You're showing signs of weakness. Uh-oh. Just collect 200,000 gold for the catalog. It's so expensive, right? So expensive. Okay, I put a flower there because I didn't have anything else to put there at the time. But now I do! A seed maker for the win! We'll move this somewhere else, actually. And I needed some hardwood to fix my fences, so let's do that. Maybe Manabit wants a flower. What do you think, guys? There you go, Manabit. Have a flower. Okay. There we go. Now we got a double wide. Lovely. I didn't even know there was a torch back here. Random. Never embrace that evil color. Okay, fair enough. 30,000 is for Pierre's for wallpapers and floors. Yeah, it's not so bad. Yeah, Catgirl, we're talking about purple. Raven's got a huge hatred towards purple, we don't know why. We gave him a bad time about it. It's okay. I know, right, Danny Chan? What's wrong with the color purple? I agree. What is wrong with the color purple? It's a lovely color. No shave November, no money November, no sleep November, no idea what I'm doing in my life November. November, November. I can't believe it's already November. It just seems like, what? What? Fruit. Fruit, 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 fruit. Okay. I need to check on the animals, and I need to get Alex a birthday gift. I was gonna see if I can make him a complete breakfast. For that, I need an egg. Let's go get some eggs. Now they've all been busy. I need a normal size egg. Come on, people. Don't do me like this. Everybody's so happy. All my subs are so happy they're giving me all large eggs. I need a little egg. I need a little egg. Guess I'm gonna use a brown one. And where's Robin? Shouldn't she be working on this today? Robin! Oh, I guess I did it today. Okay, so she's gonna be there tomorrow. Fair enough. And I need a potato. Potato. In the old times, hundreds and thousands of years ago, purple represented royalty because it was so hard to get the dye. It did. It still actually has a lot of meanings related to royalty, and, it's a good color. Pancakes? Hash browns? What do I need for the complete breakfast? There it is. Fried egg, hash browns, and pancakes. Fried egg, hash browns. No, I don't have another egg! No! Oh, well, I guess he's gonna get just normal eggs. He's gonna get a fried egg today. I do say having to watch you in black and white red is really weird. I bet. I bet it makes things a little peculiar. Happy birthday, Alex! Sorry if you hate it. For my birthday? Thanks. I smell barbecue. Damn, I could go for a burger. Me too. Me too. Can't see a stream I had to reload 700 million times, or maybe like 4. Uh-oh, cat girl. Welcome to the Purple Kingdom. You guys are funny. I wonder if my horse stall would fit right here. I wonder if that's possible. Because if it is, that would be amazing. If I could stick it right there, I'd be a happy camper. I'll stick flowers down here. Hi, everybody! Hi! Hi! My hatred for a certain color that shall not be named actually goes back to a certain little sister who happens to like a certain color and had to make everything like all that color. Oh. That makes more sense. Now we get it. No, anyone's welcome to join any of the playdates. The only time I do those special live stream playdates are the ones RSVP is necessary. But no, everybody can join today, Amber. All the subs are welcome to join the playdate. So all you have to do is show up. We'll meet on Discord, per the usual. So just meet up on Discord with us, and we will be playing from 2:30 to 4:30 p.m. Pacific Standard Time. All subs, welcome. Crimson Co-op playdate hype! And new server for the Crimson Co-op! Aw, look how cute Pudding is, speaking of new subs. Okay, I'm stuck in a perpetual talking to the animal screen. Stop it. Pudding's trying to sleep. Isn't it all mean to give someone a single blueberry on their birthday? I don't know. If it's a really good blueberry, maybe not. Wanted to double check. Yeah, you're all good. Yeah, not if blueberries are their favorite thing, like what Madjin said. Exactly. Has anyone besides you put a bomb in their house on Stardew? I have not put a bomb in my house, and I don't plan to. That doesn't seem like a good strategy. When you want your house to, you know, house you and keep you safe. So I'm gonna keep the bombs away from my house. Personally. You'll be asleep, Sabrine. Time zones do suck. I'm sorry you'll miss it today. Who are we gonna have help us make a cooking pot? You're our cooking pot guru. Used to live in a hot pink room growing up. Even the ceiling and carpet were pink. Oh wow, that's really pink, Danny. That's like devotion to your pink dreams. I wanted to paint my room black when I was a kid. My mom said no. So I had really light blue, almost, it's like a bluey, not like a baby blue, it's like a bluey purple color, I don't know. And then when we moved, when I was like 16, I painted my room walls, get this, Raven, dark purple. Like they were almost black, but it was purple. Yeah, you would have been like, fun story about that, actually. When I painted my room that dark, dark purple that was almost black, we just moved in, and my mom told me I could paint, and I've painted a million times, so it's not like I was new to painting. But, I built the paint bucket all over the white carpet. My mom wasn't very happy with me that day. You blew up part of a tree farm with bombs and started an accident. Uh-oh. Goth lace? No, I wasn't ever goth, no. I was really into design and fashion when I was younger, and I actually liked black because it was very modern at the time to do one wall in your room black and then black and white decorating, and so I was really into it, and I wanted to do black and white, and I also had a black and white bedspread as well that I saved $1 million for because I had to have it when I was a kid. And I saved my allowance and I got that bedspread and then I was like, Mom, I need my walls to match. And she's like, no. Not happening. So, you know, what can you do? Should I go to sleep? Let's get my greenhouse going. I want my greenhouse. Stat. Do it, Junimos. Do it, do it. Do it meow, do it meow. Do it, do it. Here, growing up, was black and red and had a lock on it. And my sister tried to sneak in. I used to toss my pet boa at her because it was mean and a horrible big brother. Oh, Raven.
If you guys are enjoying the stream today, please be sure to subscribe to me on YouTube, follow me on Twitter, and follow me here on Twitch. You can also subscribe to me via GameWisp to become part of the Crimson Co-op and get access to all sorts of fantastical benefits, including our playdate today, which is happening at 2:30 p.m. Pacific Standard Time. We have weekly playdate events, at least 1 to 2 a week, and we'd love to have you join the Crimson Co-op, so hit exclamation sub in a chat, or visit my website, redlacegaming.com. There's a subscribe button there. There's also a donate button if you'd like to just put a one-time donation to help support the channel. Everything goes towards making this stream a better place for everybody, so thank you so much to those of you that have chosen to donate or subscribe to me. I really appreciate it. And also visit my website to download the free indie guide to Stardew Valley and all its fantastical glory. Do check it out. 9,552 gold. White walls are boring to you, Devil's Nest. Yeah, white walls can be boring, but you can dress them up okay. Like, some places you can't paint, so, you know. Summer, Sunday the 14th. And I think it's time to upgrade another tool. What do you guys say? I think it's time. Clear and sunny all day. Spirits are in good humor today. A little extra luck. Hey! Can I hear a giant melon in my future? Greetings, it is I, the Queen of Sauce. Ah, my game's froze. Unfreeze game. I would sub, but I just got all my, just spent all my money. So sad face. Aw. Well, maybe next time, Crumbling Roses, we'll be here. Maple bars, my personal favorite, right here. If you want to make me happy, maple bars. Maple bars. Ever notice how the maple bars are always first to disappear from the donut box? I didn't do it. Perplexing, because your average maple bar tastes like a sweet hockey puck. Agree? Well, just wait until you try my recipe. You can really taste the forest in these bars, because they're probably Canadian. Okay, you're going to need real quality maple syrup, which I have in my fridge thanks to Matt Hazard! When my family moved, the walls in my room were painted to look like a zebra. That's pretty cool, Bolt. That's pretty exciting, right? My sister used to come into my room and she'd steal my clothes, which was a big issue because my sister and I were not the same sizes. And so she'd stretch out all my stuff and I'd get really mad because I was like freakishly skinny and she was not. And I would get so upset, so my dad let me put a lock in my room to keep her out from stealing my clothes. Plus she smoked, which she wasn't allowed to do, but she did anyway. So she smoked when we were kids, she was like 16. And so she'd come home after stealing all my clothes, and they'd come home stretched out and reeking of cigarettes, and I was pissed off. And by the way, we're 6 years apart, so, you know, that's why stuff doesn't fit. You know, you can see the difference here. 16-year-old sister trying to wear 10-year-old sister's clothes. Not a good idea. They don't work. Clothes don't work that way. So I was not saying my sister is fat, just to clarify that point there. Because she's not. She's a very healthy gal. My white walls hate him, but I live in an apartment, so I'm stuck with it. Me too, Danny Chan. Me too. But it's okay, I actually don't mind my white walls, because of the place, we have lots of concrete walls too, like exposed concrete. Like this wall right here, you can't see, this is exposed concrete. So I don't mind, it kind of goes with the whole modern vibe. So that's okay. I've gotten over it. You're moving on Friday, Homer. That's cool. Once you get real maple syrup, you can't go back. No, you cannot. Yeah, stick up pictures and stuff. Yeah, that's what we did. Lots of art on the walls. Art for the win! Hopefully I can find a house for starting the hunt in February. Are you looking to buy a house, Danny? That's cool. Congrats. Congratulations. Never got to paint your walls the colors you wanted to because your parents didn't like the colors, Phoenix? Well, that's too bad. You never got to let your creative spirit out. Maybe when you move out, you can do whatever you want. Whatever you want. Actually, our house we had in Portland, I painted all the walls in the whole house. It was a 3-bedroom, and I went nuts. I painted everything. I hated it how it looked. It was all white, and I was like, nope. So I fixed it. I painted it all light coffee latte browns, chocolate browns, like a really gray blue for the bathroom. I did some pretty cool color combos. People are actually at our house for the garage sale when we moved out. We're like, is your house for sale? I love the wall colors. And I was like, oh, thank you. Your older sister is always nice, but your little sister, 5 years old, is annoying sometimes. Well, she is 5. Look at all this space. What's a girl to do? I need fruit trees. I need crops. I need sprinklers. I need it all, and I need it all meow. All right, see you later, Bolt. Thanks for coming by today. Have a good one. Of course, now that you own your house, it's not painted any special colors or all fancy. It's boring country green with white crown molding. At least you have crown molding. Hey, crown molding. I couldn't buy a house. I don't know if there's a place I've been to that I'd be like, okay, I want to live here. I like moving. I like trying new places. I like being mobile. I like not having lots of stuff. And Daniel, luckily, is the same way, so we have no intentions of buying a house anytime soon. I think renting's working just fine for me. Like how light gray and light brown stuff, but things like blue, green, yellow, red for the walls just too much. I don't like yellow walls either. Yellows? I hate yellow. Like Raven hates purple, I hate yellow. True story. Hate it. Hate it with a fiery passion, yellow. Ugh. Makes me like, ugh. Ugh, can't even get into it. Yellow. Gives me the heebie-jeebies. All I want to do is paint the walls of my room black and red. Yeah, that's pretty dark. I would, I'd probably agree with your parents, because black and red are also the hardest colors to repaint, especially reds. Red's really hard, and so if you move out and they have to paint the place after you move, I can see why they wouldn't want you to paint them. That would suck for whoever has to do that job. Take like 5 coats to cover up red. I think it takes like 6 to cover up black. Both are not fun. Hey, it may have white walls, but your furniture's colorful. There you go. There you go. Black and red for the win. Yeah, you two do like black and red. Black and reds are good color combinations, I agree. I just wouldn't want to be the one to have to repaint the walls. But, you know, when I was younger, I wanted to paint my wall black, so who am I to argue? Okay, we need gold for our tool. Not feeling very focused today in Stardew. I'm feeling very wandery, so I apologize if I seem a little like, what was I doing? Because I kind of am. So apologies, y'all. You think yellow sports cars look cool? I hate yellow. Hate it with a passion! Ugh. I like it never. I can't get my horse out with this there, so I need to move it. There seems like a fine spot. Come on, Crimson. Gray's your favorite color, crumbling roses. Well, that's cool. Harvey! Guess what? I got wine for you. There you go. It's for me. This is my favorite stuff. It's like you read my mind. Imagine having a patient's life completely in your hands and failing to keep them alive. That's something that will haunt you forever. Yeah, Will. So wait, you want your duchy painted yellow and the red velvet server red? Okay, I'll get right on that for you. I don't know, Raven. Do you want your whole castle purple? Uh-huh. Try and keep the art of fishing alive. I'll pay 200 gold to any fishing enthusiast who catches 2 pike. Good luck, Willie. 200 gold reward, and you get to keep the fish. Charcoal and olive green together. Those are good colors. Those have good shway. Can you please steer animal if you got one? You did, cat, yes. I showed all the animals off at the beginning of the stream. I believe you are a goat, but I'd have to double check. Megan, do it. Diet purple. Okay. I have a plan, y'all. We are buying this bouquet, and we're gonna go pay Harvey a little visit. Because, look at that. We're at 8 hearts. Okay, Harvey. Where'd you go? Where'd he go? He's hiding. Harvey! Where the heck did he run off to? Can't find him. Well, he's fast, man. Where the heck did he go? Does anyone know where Harvey went? Oh, there he is. Harvey, I'm declaring my love for you. I'll accept this. Thank you. I didn't know you felt the same. Hey! Isn't it weird the doctor loves coffee and wine? Well, both actually have health benefits, so, you know, that could be why. Cat, remind me when I get back to the farm. I'll look for your animal. Just remind me. So we'll show it to you. Just remind me when we get back. After I do this stuff, because my brain's scattered today. So just remind me. When we get to the farm, tell me to get your animal. And we'll get him to show to you. Yellow trucks with black racing stripes. To each their own. I've never seen one, so I don't know. Okay. What to upgrade next? Let's do the hoe. We'll get ready for fall. Thanks, I'll get started on this as soon as I can. Should be ready in a couple days. Thanks, Clint, have a blueberry. Thanks. Anytime. Harvey's hiding going on. Heck no, she's got flowers running for your life. No, he's not. Lies. You know you're supposed to be an expert at this game, but if you marry a guy and give a single girl a gift, does your spouse get jealous? They used to before 1.1, but they do not any longer. I really should have come down here first before I got rid of my shovel. So no longer is that the case, but it used to be. Now jealousy's not a factor. Clint, make me a gold axe and yeah, eat this blueberry. Yeah, why not? Okay, traveling merchant. Hey Emily, have a blueberry. Thanks. Hi, Red Lace. We've become decent friends, haven't we? This may sound weird, but I've always been certain this would happen. What? How hard of any hearts do I have with her? Oh, I'm at 8. Gotcha. But Harvey's my boyfriend. Harvey, Harvey. Sorry, Majin, my info is an exclusive bot command as part of sub-benefits for my subscribers. If you want access to those exclusive bot commands, you can type an exclamation sub into chat or go to my website, redlacegaming.com, and click subscribe to see what benefits are available. Hi, Snailbot, how are you? Why is it always Worm City when you don't have your hoe? Like, I go to the mines with just your pickaxe and weapon and I always see, like, 4 worms. I know, right, Cat? Same problem. Always happens. Doesn't giving the flowers stop the other's hearts going past 8? You can give everybody a bouquet, if I remember correctly. You can get to 8. Okay. So you can go give somebody a bouquet, and then they get the 2 extra slots. So then you get them to 10 hearts, and then you can see their 10 heart cutscene. Don't give them the mermaid pendant. Then you take the bouquet and go give it to somebody else that's at 8 hearts, and then they get up to 10, and then you can see their 10 heart cutscene. And you keep doing that, and then when you're ready to marry somebody, give them back the bouquet, and then go buy the mermaid's pendant, and then you can marry that person, if that makes sense. But yeah, that's how you see everybody's 10 heart cutscenes if you want to do that before marrying, which I'm probably going to do. So that's the way it goes. Probably, I say, because I'm not sure. I'm undecided. It depends on how much time I want to involve in this game again. So I might just marry and just call it a day. We'll see. We'll see how I feel when time comes. This came from my YouTube videos. I thought the stream looked fun. Aw, thanks, Snailbot. I'm so glad you came, and thank you for watching me over at YouTube as well. Yes, tactical marriage tips. I'll have new items every week, so make sure to come back. Today she's got Speed Grow, Tulip, Summer Spangle, Life Elixir, Dish of the Sea, Yam, Radish Seeds, Sweet Pea, Yam, Sandfish, a Ceramic Pillar, a Rare Seed, and a Coffee Bean. I will take a Rare Seed because now I have the greenhouse and I need to get stuff planted in there, yo. I also need sprinklers. And oh no, I did my hoe. Crap! No! I can't believe I did that. I totally forgot that I need my hoe for the greenhouse. I didn't think about it. Crimson, I'm sorry, you can't make it through. I wonder if we move this, can you make it through? Because I don't really need that charcoal kiln there. Let's move it over and see if then we can get up. Let's try now. Let's try now, Crimson. Nope. Okay, cat, let's see where your animal is. But people get cranky if you give a single person of the same gender a gift once you're married. I don't believe they do anymore. I think they used to. That's a lot of flowers. You must be one heck of a player. Well, you know me. I always break for flowers. Okay, we're looking for cat. Lark. I think she's a goat, but I can't recall. Ben. Okay, she's not a goat. Megan. Cat. There you are, cat. You're a cow. A cute, adorable cow that goes moo and gives me milk. So play the field and confuse everyone over who you really like and break all their hearts. Chucklefish dating at its finest. Well, actually, it's Concerned Ape at its finest, but, you know, yeah, pretty much. Thank you, Matt. I'm all over it like a hot bag of chips. Oh, just let me pan. Let me pan. There we go. Darn you, ho, God, why? I know! And Cat looks fine. Yes, she does. Now I have time to plan the greenhouse layout. I know. Too bad I don't have any of my stuff I need. I could make sprinklers and get it ready anyway. Maybe I should do that. Maybe I should get sprinklers ready. That would get me a good start. Okay, so what's my forageable? A grape? Seriously? 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 3, 6, 9. Okay, so we have nothing to swap out there. I was seeing if I had iridium stuff I wanted to swap, but I don't. So glad you're a chicken's breed. Raven should have been a void chicken. I don't have void chickens yet. No void chickens. I don't have void chickens or blue chickens yet. Can you still plant fruit trees in the greenhouse? Yes, you can. Originally he took it, or had it in, and then he took it out, and then when 1.1 came back, or came out, people were really complaining about it, and so he added it back in. So now you can have trees in your greenhouse again. But only on the edge. You can put it back on the edge. Or you can plant it in the dirt either way. But yeah, you can plant it on the edge, last I heard. And yeah, they produce all year. Yep. All year. That's how I had mine on my first character that I was playing. It's on year 5. Before 1.1. I have all my trees planted on the perimeter, and it's fantastical. It's the best. The bestest. Okay, sprinklers. Can I afford iridium ones? 1 gold bar, 1 iridium, 1 battery pack. make two. Two iridium sprinklers coming right up. Okay. Go see how this will go here. Lay it out. Yeah, it's amazing. Great time saver. Planting your trees in here, you don't have to wait for the seasons. Yeah, you can plant your trees in the greenhouse, again, Phoenix. Yes! Okay, so there would be one. And there would be two. And if it goes two in, so it would grow out to there. Or water out to there. That one would water out to there. Well, that doesn't really do what I want it would to want it to. And two. Works that way. The middle wouldn't get watered though. If we did. Okay, so if I put that there. And that there, that'll water that whole side out to there. And so I would need something to cover these areas. So if I put one, two, if I put another one here, it's still have this middle strip. It's just not gonna work. Greenhouse needs to be a different size. Wonder if melons would be a good give-around gift? My experience, blueberries are a great give-around gift. Now I just need the option to get rid of the stupid bat cave and get the mushrooms. Shoulda got the mushrooms, Raven. Yeah, the fruit bats are a waste of space. Yeah, I did use the other sprinklers to get the best fit originally on my, my other greenhouse, my playthrough, but I thought maybe iridium might work better, but I don't think it's going to. Yeah, I think I'm gonna use normal sprinklers, because then I can fit them all in here. I'm gonna wait and see. I'm gonna water, let that water tonight, and see what it covers. But I think I'm gonna probably end up going with regular sprinklers, and I'll just move the iridium ones outside, because it's just not... It's not fitting how I want it to. What do I need for regular sprinklers? Gold, iron, refined quartz. Gold. Refined quartz. Ooh, I'm really low on iron. Oh, snap. Yeah, the first sprinkler is worthless. Yeah, you have to still water the corners, which is lame. I didn't even make those. Coffee is a universal love. Yeah, coffee is actually a good one. Yeah, I forgot about coffee. I need lights in here. I need to make battery packs. It's dark. It's dark and spooky. There's a guide on Steam how to design it using iridium sprinklers. That's how I did it. I like all the weathered flora on your farm. Aw, oh, thank you, Snailbot. Thank you. Okay, so if we do it this way, we still have this problem where we have to put a sprinkler out on the board, and I hate that. It's like such a waste. Remember, put sprinklers in spots so that you're not watering over things and put them next to it. Not watering over things? What? I don't know what you're saying, Kat. I'm confused. My first playthrough, I picked the fruit bats for the cave. I did the fruit bats on my second playthrough just to see what it was. And for my guide, I needed to have the second version for my guide. But yeah, the fruit bat cave. Lame. Never doing that again. Lesson learned. Alright, bedtime. Wish you could upgrade the sprinklers instead of having to make new ones. That would be nice if you could, Danny. I agree. 9,614 gold.
I'll be back in just a second, everybody. I'm back. Always forget to- ow! Ouch. Always forget to check the cave, so you don't mind that cave. I always forget to check it too, Amber. I usually check it every 3 days when my fruit trees are ready, and then I'll go check it, because I just don't care. My mushrooms can just grow, it's fine. You chose the hilltop farm recently, Snailbot? The hilltop farm's a cool one. I like it. I like Hilltop Farm. I have another character on Hilltop Farm, but I'm only in Spring Here 1, so I haven't played very much. I'm like 15 days in, I think. Start with Hilltop Explored Land and thought, how the heck can you have a farm here? Yeah, you have to be more creative with the Hilltop Farm, for sure. It's gonna be clear and sunny all day, because land is limited. You get daily hardwood and you get to upgrade, or you get forgeable items. Yeah, the Forest Farm I like for the unlimited hardwood. That was my decision maker. What's the unlimited hardwood? Spirits are in good humor today, extra luck. I like it, but you're having trouble finding space for a barn. Yeah, I can't even remember how big the area is, but you're probably gonna have to really clear something out for that. You started a hilltop one yesterday, Danny? Nice. Game, wake up. I know it's hard, but stop worrying so much about your horse. You can leave them anywhere and they'll make their way back home. They're very smart and independent animals. That was living off the land. Yeah, I like the forest farm. I like all the shrubbery and stuff. I liked the look of it. Like the outer room where it makes you feel like you're deep in the forest. Yeah, totally, Kat, me too. Used to 2 coops and spoiled so I wouldn't feel comfortable on the hilltop. I usually have 2 coops too, Amber. I like one for all my chickens, and I like one for my rabbits. I like having them separated. So at some point I'll probably get a 2nd coop as well. I don't like having them in the same one. I'm very weird about it. Dear Farmer Red Lace, I'd like to give my wife a starfruit for our anniversary. Are you growing any on your farm? If you brought me one, I'd be very grateful. Kent. And it's just Kent's luck that this happens to be a starfruit right there. We just have to wait for it. And we got one more day until my hoe is ready again. So we'll go ahead and plant some stuff in here. Okay, I guess that thing that I'm trying to grab that I can't grab, and I'm grabbing the other stuff instead. That's like it's, I'm not ready to be harvested. So that's not 1 coop for each animal, so she could have 8 of each. Yeah, yeah, I think that's a great way to do it. I like having lots of coops as well. I'd like to have multiple barns this time around also. I'm not doing a slime hutch. I hate the slime hutch. I don't like the look of the slime hutch. It doesn't match anything. It bothers me. So I'm not doing a slime hutch this time. And I never really went into my slime hutch. It was more of a hassle to me, I felt like, because I had to put on that slime charmer ring and then go inside and then do all my stuff and then come out. It didn't seem worth it. So I'm skipping it this time around. Trying really hard not to accidentally pull out my poppies, because I do that. Okay, I need to go get some wheat seeds or something. Still no giant melon. Come on, giant melon. Gotta go buy wheat seeds today, it appears. Check on all my animals. The watering can, or the milking can. Even blue chickens? Oh yeah, blue chickens. I want blue chickens really badly. I think I'm gonna start selling off my animals that are 5 hearts and then getting a new one, the same name. So like, if you're at 5 hearts and a sub, I might swap you out and see if I can get a blue chicken. So you might get lucky and get a blue one.
You never know. I did, I got the blue chicken cutscene last time I played Stardew. If you guys missed it, you can check it out over my YouTube channel at Red Lace Gaming. My sheep pudding looks fine. Still a baby. They should make it where you can hire Shane or Sam if you didn't marry him to come work on your farm instead of working at Joja Cola. That'd be a neat idea. I think it'd be cool if you could hire anybody on your farm. Like, maybe they'd do something specific for whatever that they're into. Like, Emily could come, you know, make tapestries or curtains or something for your house. I mean, you could think of all sorts of things. Still need a couple tree tappers. That one tree still has not grown. What is its deal? What is your deal, tree? Nothing's blocking it. It's the weird thing. I've, like, tested it multiple times to make sure nothing's in its way. It's just stubborn. Where's bone meal when you need it, right? Hire Linus. Oh, I like Linus. He's a pal. Him and his Fred Flintstone outfit are the best. My peppers be a poppin'. Time to check the mushrooms today. When the fruit's ready, the mushrooms are ready. Linus reminds you of Santa Claus. Reminds me of Fred Flintstone. Or Barney. I already spent half the day working on the farm, even with sprinklers. I feel like that's all I do, so I'm burnt out. Yeah. You can spend a long amount of time on the farm, yeah, before you know it, you're like, oh, it's 1 o'clock in the afternoon. Awesome. Is that just my quest blinking at me? Starfruit. I don't know if I have one, like, backstopped. Should check. I would say that is the point of Stardew, Matt, to work on your farm, yeah. That's why I find decorating a good way to spend your time in Stardew. Because it never gets old. You can constantly change it. If you get sick of something, you can move stuff around. That was a sneaky egg. I almost didn't see it. You wanted to marry Linus because you wouldn't be homeless anymore? Totally. I'd like to mine, talk to villagers, explore the school cavern, discover quests, do things like that. No, I thought this would have left watermarks, but I guess I was wrong. We're definitely going to be doing regular sprinklers, so this just isn't going to work out this way. Thank you for the follow, Norskun. You are fantastical, meow. Welcome to the stream. Oh yeah. Guys, I forgot all about it. I can knock down my meteor and get my iridium. So I got my gold pickaxe, let's do it. Let's break down this meteor. Iridium! 6 iridium ore, 2 geodes, and 6 stone. Thank you kindly. Where are my chickens at? And my ducks. They go quack. Hey man, a bit, you need some water in that bowl? There you go, buddy. There you go. I'm gonna get stuck in here with the chickens, I can tell. Someone's out behind the house. I know, I need the hoe! I need the hoe, yo! I don't have it. Okay, so we need 1 coal. 2 coal. And 4. Let's go to town and get some seeds. I need wheat. I don't have a starfruit yet. I'm still waiting on mine to grow. Starfruit wine is the way to go because 5 ancient fruit wine and 5 starfruit wine and ancient fruit wine sells for only 200 gold more. Do you want your sprinkler layout map? Sure, why not? Can't hurt. I'm probably just gonna do it the same way I did it in my first playthrough, where I just do it all like I have it on the right side all the way across. But if you have a different layout that works better, I'd love to see it. Maybe you should put a fence down by the area with the lake and the crab pots out towards your greenhouse. A fence? Oh, you mean like a fence gate? Yeah, maybe I should, so I can walk through there. Maybe. Wanted, slime hunter to slay 8 red slimes in the deep lava caverns of the local mine. 1,000 gold reward. And I might very well go do that, because... ugh. It's not Wednesday, Caroline. Because, I'd like to get some copper. Although that's not on the right levels. Psh. Might be able to get some, though. Okay, wheat. Wheat, 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 wheat. You know I'm planting blueberries in there. You know it. And melons to make pink cake. Get rid of some of this stuff. Wheat, radish, poppy, spangle. Hops, corn, sunflowers, cabbage. Get some cabbage. Do people use mics and playdates? Yeah, Amber. Pretty much most people do have a mic, and we talk on Discord, but some people also type in chat if they don't have a mic available. So, all works. Yeah, you can also just listen if you're uncomfortable talking. You're not expected to talk if you don't like to. Does anybody love blueberries? No, nobody does. I think it's just a like for people. I don't think anyone loves blueberries. Okay. Buying trees. So, let's start from the top. Cherry. Do cherry, apricot, and then I'll do the summer ones next time. Do 2 at a time. That way I know what I have. Welcome back, Raven. Pineapple's good too? Pineapple's delicious. Right, I was wondering if you make your own pumpkin pie, since nutmeg is a common ingredient, and with your being allergic to nuts, I'm worried me hearing you like it so much. No. Funny thing. Nutmeg doesn't bother me. I don't think nutmeg is actually even a nut. We've had this conversation with our local bakery a few times, because it doesn't seem to affect a lot of people that are allergic to nuts, and they've wondered too. They're like, people come in all the time and ask about nutmeg, but I don't think it's a nut, and we were like, we don't think it is either, because I've eaten nutmeg before. And I actually cook with nutmeg, so no, nutmeg doesn't bother me. Yeah, I don't know what the deal is with nutmeg. There's something weird about nutmeg that makes it not... it's like not in the nut category. I don't know if it's because it's not... doesn't have the oils on it like nuts have. I don't know. Hi, 44 Russia, how are you? Blueberry pie, Sheldon yells, stop, blueberries are full of antioxidants. What happens if we run out of oxidants? Oh boy. Okay, I was gonna get rid of some things. I got that money, honey. Why is my starfruit taking its sweet time? Grow faster, starfruit. Get my wheat planted. Wheat for the win. I can't even see down there if stuff's there or not. It's like a total guessing game. Okay. Your nephew can't have it. He's allergic to nuts, so you're just wondering. That's interesting. Yeah, it doesn't... nutmeg is the only thing that doesn't bother me. And, I don't know. Is nutmeg actually a nut? Because if it is, that might be the only nut I can have. Sometimes you feel like a nut, other times nutmeg. Nutmeg's actually a seed kernel of fruit, nutmeg, so it's not actually nut. Yeah, see, I didn't think it was actually a nut either. Yeah, from what I knew, it wasn't a nut. I knew it was something else, a seed kernel, yeah, so that explains it. Thank you, Raven, for that information. I'll have to tell Daniel, because him and I have been wondering, going back and forth about it. If I remember what I'm allergic to, sulfa. I don't know what it is, but it gives me a rash. Sulfa. I don't know what that is either. It sounds familiar. I want to know what it is. Okay, let's get these trees into the greenhouse. Since I'm still waiting on my hoe, till tomorrow. Purple power. Not a nut, never a nut. Okay, so I could plant one right here. Seems like that would be in the way, doesn't it? Guess not, because it's going to let me stick it there. Don't they have to have four spaces of empty around them? I thought they had to be here. I think that might not work there. I'm going to put one here and see. Because I don't know. I thought it was going to tell you if you couldn't plant something somewhere, but it doesn't seem to want to tell me that. Now I'm confused. Is it sulfa or sulfur? Yeah, I know what sulfur is, but sulfa, I don't know what that is. It sounds like sofa. Like when I've had my color filter on, all I see is you saying stuff in black text. Sulfa, I keep thinking I'm literally just sulfate because the name is so similar, but it's sulfa. Interesting. I wonder what it is. Yours are against the wall and growing, Raven? Oh, well, crap. Now I'm gonna have to do mine like this so it looks cool and not abnormal. Hi, Alyssa! How are you today? I used all my wood up on the upgrade to my animal pen, which, by the way, next subscriber can be a bunny rabbit. Hey! Bunny hype. Bunny hype. I think it's some kind of antibiotic. Huh. Where's Nurse Taco when you need her? She'd know the answer to this question. She'd know if it's an antibiotic. Don't we have another person that's a nurse on the Crimson Co-op? Or is it just Taco? Taco was saying she thought someone else was a nurse, but I didn't know anybody else that was. Tree still hasn't grown. Try being allergic to honey, it's a nightmare. Oh no, honey, I love honey. I'd be bummed if I was allergic to honey. Are you allergic to bees as well, Danny? Or just honey? Getting all my hardwood. Watch 12 seasons of Grey's Anatomy. I consider myself a doctor. I am watching Grey's Anatomy myself, but I'm only on like season 6, I think. I've been watching it on Netflix occasionally when I get bored. I'll watch Grey's Anatomy. But when Jane the Virgin came out again, the new season, I had to switch over to that, so I haven't watched it in a few weeks. By the way, all you purple lovers in here, if you're scared of clowns, I totally have the perfect outfit to pay you a visit. Oh, no, Raven. Let's not say you did. It's the only way to go on a vast hive of information to look up what stuff is. That thing called Google. It's a thing called Google. Okay, should I? I think I have enough wood now to make some lampposts. So we can go stick these in the greenhouse. Since it gets dark and spooky in there apparently at night. Not allergic at all? Yay for you. Well, that's good. Can't find your cow, Snailbot. Uh-oh. Well, at least he'll go turn himself in at night. They always return, so no worries. He'll be back. Let there be light. Lovely. Sabrine, I have an allergy to idiots. Does that count? Why about what happened to our purple party? Give me a break. And Raven, I laugh in your face of clowns. Oh, goodness. Oh, goodness. Take that to Clint when I go pick up my hoe, which I can get tomorrow. Finally. I should keep these ancient fruit. I need to turn these ancient fruit into seeds, actually. Seed me! Not to be confused with Seymour! A bee sting caused me to be allergic to honey, but yes, I'm allergic to bees as well as beeswax. Interesting. The bee sting caused your allergy to honey. That's a bummer. That's awful. Darn bees, don't they know? Don't they know that you like honey? They're infringing on your honey-eating rights. Radish. Don't choke on your sprite, cat. Don't choke on your sprite. Choking is no good. What will you place where the old tapper farm was? A barn? No, I'm gonna put a, right here, I'm going to put the, what are they called? The new buildings that you store stuff in? I'm drawing a blank. Oh man, what are those called? Somebody help me out! Things you store stuff in a shed. Ah, I'm gonna put a shed there and then put my artisan goods in the sheds. So I'll have a couple sheds. Like how I live in the sunniest place on earth but still have a vitamin D deficiency. I have to take vitamin D supplements because I live in Seattle, and actually pretty much everyone in Seattle has a vitamin D deficiency because it's so gray all the time. So you actually have to take vitamin D supplements if you live here. Might be able to get two coops there. Yeah, I'm putting my coops up top, though, where the other one is. I'm gonna put my other one up there with it. Getting cold in your house, you might have to start a fire, Matt. That's probably a good idea. During the night, Frailia gave birth to a baby cow. Megan's a mom! Hugs to Megan! Let's give Megan some hugs in chat, everybody. She is now a mama. Danny Chan! Let's give hugs to Danny Chan! She just subscribed at Diamond! Danny! New sub hype, Danny Chan's gonna be a rabbit, da da da! Let's get your name in the frame, Danny Chan! Thank you so much for the support, it means a ton. You make the stream a better place for everyone. And I rhymed there, I didn't even know it. I'm a poet! I'm on a roll. You guys can stop me anytime. So, thank you for the host, Cat Girl! So, Danny, make sure to check your game wisp and answer all the questions that I need answered from you there so that I can fulfill all your sub benefits as soon as possible. Thank you so much for choosing to subscribe to me. Let's get your name in the fantastical VIP board. Danny Chan. Danny Chan 13. Yeah. Even Lexus is excited. She's like, new sub hype! Yeah. Yeah. Well, you can't sit on me right now. I'm writing a name. Yeah, I know. World's ending. Oh, I know. She's so excited. Give me just a minute, Miss Kitty. This pen's all messed up. The tip of it's all blunky. Danny Chan! Hi! 13. 417 fantastical hugs going Danny Chan's way. Yay! What a lovely day. I'm still rhyming, guys. This is ridiculous. Me and my rhyming right now. Maybe that's why Alexis is like, stop rhyming, Mom. Now we all watch as Red keeps an eye on chat, so I shouldn't misspell your name. I know that'd be the worst. I'd feel so bad if I spelled someone's name incorrectly.
Danny Chin. Oh, Alexis. Okay, come here. Come here. And you get some Lexus cat loving too. Danny Chan. Oh, Lexus cam time. She's too excited. We will resume in just a moment, everybody.
Oh yeah, don't do it in Firefox. We've discovered that doesn't work. Actually, Catgirl, Rose is the chicken dinner winner on the highest sub tier. She's Iridium. Yeah, amazing, Rose.
Danny Chan. Hey.
Okay. Danny Chan, would you like to be the new baby brown cow, or would you like to be a rabbit? I think she's in chat still, right? She didn't go anywhere.
Danny. Cow or rabbit? Cow or rabbit? Cow, rabbit, cow, rabbit, cow, 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 rabbit, rabbit, rabbit.
The new update ruined your life. I used to put fruit trees all around the park in the community center and around Robin's house, and you can't do that anymore. Oh, I never tried to put trees out anywhere around in the wild.
Danny, are you still there?
I'm gonna have to name the new cow Lexus. The Wildebeest. What if they want to be a rabbit cow? I don't know if that would work. Yeah, it does say she's still in chat. Yeah, I thought she was still here. I might name her after the cow, and if she wants to be a rabbit, well, I'll change it.
Danny Chan.
She wants to be a bunny. Okay. So, this can be the baby cow, can be the wildebeest.
I named it after you, Miss Kitty.
4,366 gold. And let's go get Danny a bunny.
Yeah, Manly. Yeah, buddy.
That's the first animal I've ever had give birth, by the way. I've never had that happen. I've been very unlucky in that department. So it's Tuesday the 16th. No birthdays today.
Yeah, Megan's a mom.
You just gave birth to a wildebeest. Which sounds really messed up. It's going to be clear and sunny all day. I see a glimmer within my scrying orb. The spirits are perturbed today.
Oh no.
Like how I had two teen mom sheep.
Hey, it's Leia. Hi, Red Lace. Are you free this afternoon?
I finally got my act together and I'm going to my art show tonight in the town square. Come into town between 3 and 5 p.m. if you want to be there. Okay, well, we have to do that today. No giant melon yet.
Melon?
Where's the baby? Here it is. The wildebeest. Wildebeest's still a little clumsy from being born. She's curious about her new world. Parent, Frelia. I should have let Megan name him. Can I rename him? Oh, I can't rename him.
Darn it.
If only you were here, Megan. You could have named him. It's your baby. Could you name the bunny rabbit, or the rabbit Bunny Chan? I don't know if that'd fit, though. Sure, I'll try, Danny.
Sure. Bunny Chan.
Let me tend to these guys, and then I will go get the wabbit. The waskly wabbit. I also need to go get my hoe today. Someone help me remember, please. Wait until it grows up. You like Builder Beast? Okay, lovely. Looks like my sheep's ready to be sheared, but I don't have shears. I'm gonna have to buy some from Marnie as well. I'm down there. Matt, you just boinked at me. Again. I'm not trying to milk the wildebeest or Matt. My mouse is all over the place. For some reason, you never get the cutscene for Leia about sculptures in town. Weird. Okay. Manly! Why so chatty, buddy? What's going on? Both of them, like, all of a sudden out of nowhere, they're like, ah! Danny Chan swirled him into a frenzy. Oh no, it's ladies' workout day! I'll have to get Bunny Chan tomorrow. I'm gonna make a note. Bunny Chan. Bunny Chan. Grab it. So I don't forget. Because I can't go down right now like I wanted to. What did I just eat? Catgirl just upgraded their subscription to Iridium! Oh my goodness, Catgirl! That's so generous of you! Be sure to, in a few minutes, give it a little while because it takes a minute to update, but go to GameWisp again and fill out all your other stuff so we can get you your new fantastical benefits! Thank you! Thank you! Greater. Give some hugs to Catgirl in chat, everybody! She's at Iridium. I think the pig needs to be on dirt. I think you're right. I think the pig does need to be on dirt. I think you're cramping my style by keeping me in a small pen. I need a larger area to find you truffles. I think I do need to put you somewhere where you can actually get dirt. I think you're right. 419 fantastical hugs! Going out, right meow. I'm useless as an animal that makes me useful as food. Yum. Pork shoulder. Barbecue pork. No bacon though. I'm hating on the bacon. Well, one thing Matt is not short of is maple syrup, so maple-flavored bacon. Oh, there you go. The game just decided to be frozen. There we go. I guess I should see if my... It would probably help, too, if my coop's been fully upgraded. It should be today, right? It's been a while. Making wine and jam because we can. I see sparkles in the water. Sparkles in the water. Can I get there before they disappear? Can I? Quack! Haha, I made it. I'm panning. 3x mana bit multiplier is tempting. Yeah. It's a lot of mana bits. Well, and the swag bag. I mean, come on. Swag! Mana bit is crashed. Meow. Yes, I won't forget my hoe. Thank you, Sabrine. I definitely need my hoe. Yep, my hutch is all automated now and ready for some wascally wabbits. Let's get this stuff down here.
Oops. Manly, what you doing, buddy? Coming to visit?
He's like, maybe. I didn't know the wildebeest was here.
Man.
He's like, aw, man. I just got a heart event with Emily. I'm not going to spill anything, but I do feel sorry for Clint. Aww. Yeah, poor Clint. He's a good guy. Just in case we run into Harvey, we'll hang on to one of those. It's hop-tastical around these parts. I don't like hops because they grow every day. It's like extra work. Like, I wish they would just harvest themselves.
Manly! What is it, little dude?
Okay. Let's go get my hoe back. Hidey ho, Crimson. We need also the art event, which I think she said starts at 3. So let's see if it even lets me in the town square. It might tell me I have to come back later. Oh, good. You mean mana bits, cat girl? Mo mana bits! Mo mana bits! Ugh, stuck. Well, there's lots of ways you can earn mana bits, cat. Check out exclamation earn to find out all the ways you can earn mana bits. And you get fat multiplier now since you are a sub of amazingly high tier. So that's bonus. 3 times the mana bits on donations, playdate events, special offers, giveaways. Lots of ways to use those multipliers. Alexis, you have a big chunk behind your ear. Received a gold hoe! Yay! I got my hoe back. Thanks, Clint. And I also have a geode for you. Or two. If you'd like to make it a dino egg, I'd really appreciate it. It's like, no, I'll give you rocks. Rocks and granite. Oh, thanks. Okay, let's go down to the beach and do the digging that we didn't get to do last time, and then it'll probably be time for Leia's art event. And I might go to sleep early so I could name Danny's animal before the stream ends. I came for the sound of the ocean. Beautiful, isn't it? Hi, Brianna! She's just gonna keep telling us how beautiful that ocean is, too, if we let her. Come on, dino egg. You know you want to make yourself into a baby dinosaur. Who has the pliers? I see the minigame's going and it's getting passed. Oh, cat had him. Gotcha. At least it's only one mana bit though, right? At least it's only one. Okay, 2:20, it's almost 3 o'clock. Leia, don't you have somewhere to be right about now? Like, shouldn't you be setting up for your art event? Hey there, Willie. I got some stuff for you. Pleasure doing business. I should have brought gold bars. I could have upgraded another tool now. 250. Hey, Alex. Or, Sam, have a blueberry. I just called him Alex. It's okay. 3 o'clock. Here we go. Leia's art event.
Alexis, I'm getting fur in my face. Oh, look at it. It's fantastical. Everybody's here. Red Lace, you're here! Okay, I guess I better introduce my pieces. Wish me luck. Good luck, Leia. I like that her pieces move. I want her giant purple one. Okay, everyone. Oh, she's so nervous. Thanks for coming to my art show. How was Don't Starve Together yesterday? We played Don't Starve Together on Halloween on Monday, but we haven't played it since Monday, and we'll be playing it again this afternoon at 2:30 for the sub play date. Yeah. And Danny, I'll fill out all your sub benefits. If you've done your end of stuff, I'll get my end done so you can get access to the playdate today, so we'll get you on Discord so you can come if you'd like to come to the playdate. As some of you know, I came to this town because I wanted to draw inspiration from the beautiful surroundings. Want the tall Mr. Peanut Guy looking statue. This place really feels like home now. Okay, I'm going to introduce my sculptures now. I haven't named this one yet. She started out as an exercise in human anatomy, but I ended up seeing her through to completion. Her expression is intentionally unclear. Is she embarrassed, amused, pained? I'll leave that for you to decide. This one's called Post-Dimensional Null Space. It represents the boundary of human imagination. The shape and color came to me vividly when I was in a trance state. Yeah, it seems like a raver statue. I've been calling this one Eggheads. I wanted to create an animatronic humanoid statue to toy with the viewer's ability to properly attribute personhood to a physical entity. Leia's got a lot of big words in that vocabulary. Hi, Technomeister! How are you? Glad you stopped in to say hello. And the last one is called Wood Sculpture 3. It's a celebration of my favorite sculpting material, wood. Of course it is. Well, those are my sculptures. Oh, one last thing. I'd like to say thanks to my special friend, Red Lace. She gave me an idea for this show and the courage to go through with it. I know that sounds cheesy, but it's true. Awesome, Danny. Yeah, we'd love to have you come today. I'm proud of you, Leia. Events like this really breathe life into our little town. I love your art, Leia. Post-dimensional null space is my favorite.
Thanks for doing this.
Everybody loves it, Leia. See, you're very well received. Thanks, everyone.
Out of all the statues, she gives us the crappy weird wood weird thingy statue. I think they should make it random, so you just get a random one. Like, that'd be cool if everybody had a different one. Now let's start the bidding on these wonderful art pieces, a marvelous addition to your home. Do I hear 5,000 gold for the pink one? Techno lives down under, and so his time zone, it's tomorrow for him when it's today for us. Okay. Marnie best be there tomorrow morning. We're gonna go to sleep right meow so we can go get the Danny Chan, her animal. 1 million for Mr. Peanut. Seems like a good price. More apples. Alright, to bed! We're going to bed at 3:40 in the afternoon, like a little lady. Well, people are buying statues and that explains why we only get the wooden one. But what if someone bought the wooden one? 8,325 gold! But yeah, I guess that makes sense if they start bidding off the purple one. You know, you obviously couldn't have the purple one. I wonder if she stole ours out of the house to put it in into the show. It's going to be clear and sunny all day. Spirits are very happy today. Do I hear a giant melon? Oh, I have mail. Do
Dear Red Lace, thanks again for coming to my art show. It was such a success. I sold nearly all of my sculptures, and everyone was so positive and encouraging. I hope to see you again soon. Leia.
Yay.
No giant melon yet. Why, cruel world? Why? Why, oh why?
I think the people at the bottom lived in other towns. They came from far away. It could be, yeah, because we don't see them in anyone else's house. Technically, we're all living in someone's past thanks to amazing time zones. It's funny to think about it that way, isn't it? Recyclables. Alright, Matt, we'll see you at the playdate. Maybe we should let Matt roam around out here in the dirt. Let him out. Leave the gate open for him. Okay, Marnie. Danny needs a rabbit.
Wish you could speed time like in Skyrim. That'd be fantastical.
Yeah, it'd be really difficult if we had just one time, because it'd be nighttime for somebody that's noon somewhere else, and it'd be daytime for them. It'd be very confusing. You actually make things $1.99 instead of $2 because people subconsciously think it's cheaper if it's $1.99. Where they see $2, they think it's more expensive. It's an old marketing trick from way back in the day, and that's why lots of things cost $3.99 or $20.99 or whatever, instead of having it actually be the other value up. It seems deceptively cheaper than it is, so that's why they do that. Marketing. Marketing fluff. Alright, Megan, we'll see you at the playdate. 10 minutes. Marnie better be there. Yeah, I wish you could travel and fast travel in Skyrim. She's here! Yay! Okay, Danny. Rabbit time. I'm frozen. Rabbit. Okay. Danny Chan, newest sub, we are naming it Bunny Chan. Per her request. Great, I'll send little Bunny Chan to her new home right away. And I also need to buy some shears while we're here for our sheep pudding. Yay, lovely. You watched my Skyrim vid on YouTube and it's officially you're no longer the Dragonborn, you're a merchant. You spend too much time in stores. I like spending lots of time in stores, and you know, that was my first time in Whiterun on this playthrough, and usually my first time in a new city, I do spend a lot of time in the shops talking to everybody. And so my first time in a city, I do spend a lot of time in the shops. It's pretty normal for me. Okay, where's the rabbit? Where is she hiding? We must find the rabbit. Look at all these eggs going real fast. What should you call your goat? I don't know, Snailbot. What do you want to call your goat? Danny, where are you? You're hiding. Anybody see a rabbit? A bunny rabbit? We have an escapee. Oh, there you are! I found you. Look at how cute you are.
Bunny Chan. Bunny Chan seems curious, but a little cautious. It's a strange new world. Billy, there's a good name. Be very, very quiet. She's hunting rabbits. Vincent Van Gogh, that's so cute. I like that. Yay! We got a new goat. Or we got a new bunny. Now I got goat stuck in my head. Thanks to chat. Alright guys, I gotta wrap this up because I got a playdate to be out with my subscribers. So thank you everybody for hanging out. It's been fantastical fun, and thank you to everybody that subscribed and upgraded their subscriptions today. You are all fantastical. And I will be back tomorrow at 12 noon Pacific Standard Time for some more Skyrim Special Edition, speaking of. And then it's a double stream tomorrow as well, so I'll be also streaming from 4 to 6 in Titanfall 2, so I hope to see you guys there. And also, be sure to visit my website, redlacegaming.com, where you can download the free indie guide to Stardew Valley, as well as help support the channel by subscribing via GameWisp or making a donation. Everything helps make the stream a better place to be for everybody. And also subscribe to me on YouTube, follow me on Twitter, and follow me here on Twitch, all at Red Lace Gaming. So it's been fun, and I will see the Crimson Co-op in a short bit for some Don't Starve Together. It should be fun, so meet us on Discord if you want to play and earn some bonus mammoths. See you guys soon. Thanks for hanging out, everybody. Bye.